Sisya, omongin yang biar dari kebunyi Kutoa adhabu Thank you. Kwa hivyo naomba Bishop Perez Monsignor Dennis Lile aweze kukaribia ili aweze kukaribishwa na mashaka Baba Askofu. Karibu. Anapokelewa na askofu mkuu. Makofi kwa Yesu.
John chapter 15 verse 9. May the peace of Christ with the Blessed Virgin Mary and protect us, and with the patron saints, Peter and Paul, of these diocese interceding, be with you always, and the descendants, ecclesial community, and the beloved healing ministry of St. Paul, the Diocese of Friends and Church of Christ International. Give in my generous St. Paul's Cathedral, Lublin, Malawi, on the ninth day of the month of January, in the year of the Lord 2023, the 14th year of our episcopate, Most Reverend Daniel Maboa Kasuo.
Tutajenga sisi sote tumshukuru. Kwa Kiswahili, Father Charles.
You know, it makes for the days of the life. And I know that Yet, as our first reading says, God walked with him in the womb, appointed him for his mission, and promised him the strength to carry it out. When God says to Jeremiah, "Before you are born, I consecrated you," he makes the mission of the prophet, and by extension, the mission of the bishop, something unique, personal and sacred. This is why every bishop has a special need for the virtues of faith and courage, and for the friends of his people in remaining strong in his ministry. Once we read a letter to Peter, tells us how the bishop should carry out his work. Number one, with humility to Jesus. Christ has the people in his care. Number two, with generosity and self-sacrifice. Instead of grumbling and shifting the burdens of leadership to others. Third, with humility. Instead of a hunger, personal advancement, and a shameful gain. And fourth, with gentleness and patience in the personal witness of integrity. So, that is what vision is supposed to be according to letter written to Peter. But in the end, it's today's gospel reading that names the fundamental profession of a bishop. That is, seeing to it that, since the deliverance of you, to pray, and to see in what way can the deliverance increase.
Caring for standing in a minute.
scarecrow. In one of that scenario, his human life is a vision of the hope of finding a connection. That's the vocation of a vision of the human child. That's the way of every man who wants to be a successor of the apostles. The Lord's choice of each one of us to be his disciple is rigid, is religious, all those of them expresses the mysterious and particular reality of divine providence. Finding ourselves over by God, to a place we never imagined in the success of faith. Also, another saying by Hermes the Pythagorean gives us wise and wonderful counsel. Let us detach ourselves from spirit, he said, from all that we see, and cling to that which we believe. Only by faith we truly live and flourish contemporarily. Faith is the Son of God who loves us, who loves the deadness of our ambition to be, and who gave his life. So, dear brother, have within you that peace which is the gift of the risen Christ. Thank you for your yes. This is what Father Luther is. Thank you for your yes. I remember my husband said several times, I want to retire, I want to retire. And I was a patient with the mission. I remember what we were exiting from us, and I think in that it's you are not retired, Papa. Nikakuta kwa nyumbani mama mama ananiambia Papa. Siku ingine nikamuuliza ananiambia Papa. Actually, Bishop Bibo Zoguru, he could have told me, no, we will have been in the city yet again. Because he never said that, he's very polite. He's very polite to speak to you. So, this is where let us retire our search of spirit from all that we have and cling to that which we believe. Only by faith and we truly live and flourish authentically. Faith in the Son of God who loves us, who loves you in the midst, who gave his life for us. And so, dear brother, in the midst, have within you peace which is the gift of the risen Christ. Thank you for your yes to a future and hope to you. Because once God calls you to be a bishop, it is a future that is much more to you. But remember, Jeremiah, we are born, I knew you, and I consecrated you. Remember, Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Let your years be shaped by the unique years of blessed manna. Remember the blessed manna, when the children are gathered to her, and she will have with the deposition of her hands. Through the imposition of my hands and the hands of your co-consecrators in the apostolic succession in that life, through the prayer of the child, a prayer that embodies the prophetic word, and through the anointing of the sacred prison, you will be able to say, yes, dear Jesus, the Spirit of the Lord of God is upon you. The Spirit was who consecrates you in the truth of Christ and sends you forth to proclaim it. This outward came out of those first apostles who became friends of the Lord Jesus. Bishop Abed, do all you can to all the people of our diocese to an ever unlearning and enjoyable friendship in our Savior, and not least by your own example. Lead our priests and deacons towards a renewed personal relationship with God. Bishop Lent, have a lovely way of describing the ministry. Try, it is difficult, but try. To be an extension of the love of Christ in the service of the Spirit. These characters are the essential for what it means to bear fruit for the sake of God's people. Bishop Lent is a bishop. Be an extension of the love of Christ in the service of His people. It will not always be easy, but we must renew this intention each day. Your episcopal ordination is a consecration in and to the love of Christ. Our episcopal ministry is never God's strengthening our need. By such a love, which is God accepted and given, we can transmit what we have received, the great treasure of good news of salvation. We do this, St. Paul reminds us, through the transcendent power, that is power we grasp, which later comes from us, no belongs to us, but which always belongs to and has to Almighty God. All episcopal ministry, dear missionary like ladies, is subject to the power of God. In a few moments, the gospel will literally be preached by you, as a open door. By preaching and teaching this person of the nation of this ministry, who he was the one who proclaimed and the master such a language. So too, we will now hear St. Paul advising you, set an example for those who believe in speech, conduct, pay attention.
Pay careful attention to the Lord. I am. Christ our Lord.
Kwa hivyo atakuwa amepiga magoti mbele ya mkono na askofu mkuu.
God the Father of our Lord Jesus. From the beginning, you chose the descendants of Abraham to be your holy nation. You established rulers and priests, and did not leave your sanctuary without ministers to serve you. From the creation of the world, you have been pleased to be glorified by those whom you have chosen. Father, you know of all us. You have chosen a servant for the office of bishop. May he be a shepherd to your flock and a helpless blameless in your sight. Ministering to you night and day, may he always gain the blessing of your favor and offer the gifts of your holy church. Through the Spirit, give the grace of high priesthood, granting him the power to give saints as you are commanded. To assign ministries as you are to pray, and to lose every bond by the authority which you gave to your apostles. May he be pleased to you by his gentleness and purity of heart, presenting a fragrant offering to you through Jesus Christ, your Son, who through whom glory and power of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and the Lord of all consolation, to dwell in heaven and hear to you with the compassion of all that is to come.
Thank you.
Uma boa fechada.
Receive the mitre and may the splendor of ordination fall the news on that when the chief shepherd appears, you may deserve to receive from him an unfading crown of glory.
Katika Roma kila Amen. We are the stars of the
for the rebellion of our service of you, so that all your brothers are holy as we are, you may graciously pray to fulfill it through Christ our Lord. Lord, give you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give up to the Lord. It is true that the prayer of the cross of nation always is a prayer to give you up to the Lord of our men and our Lord. For by the anointing of your spirit, you make your own people and son. I give you the new man and our Lord. I pray you are wondrous beside who are pleased to you. What is one which you should continue to be judged? For Christ family adorns with a lot of people, the people he has made his own, but with their brother's kindness he also chooses them to become heirs in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human invention, to say before your children the past of public, to lead your people in the church in charity, to nourish them in the world and strengthen them in their sacraments, as they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters. They strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you the constant goodness of faith and love. And so, Lord of all the angels and saints, we do give you thanks in excellence.
Your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter, Paul, and Paul,
Thomas James Philip Bartholomew Magnus Emmanuel Linus Gregus Clement Sixtus Cornelius Cyprian Cornelius Chrysostomus John Paul Cosmas and Damian and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may by your protecting hand. On the day before he was going to suffer, be pleased, O God, we pray, that you may be blessed and grown in knowledge and approve his offering in every respect, making his individual and acceptable, so that he may become for us the body and blood. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread and released holy venerable hands and in his highest praise to heaven, to whom all God is mighty, God, give me your hands, his every blessing, broke the bread and gave it to the poor, say, take it all of you and in of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you.
Grant them, O Lord, we pray, those who in Christ, blessed with the resurrection.
All of
decided to come to Blessing Church of Christ International, jimbo mzima, tumepata mchungaji mwingine, mchungaji mpya katika huduma yetu. Tumsifu Yesu Kristo. Kama unafurahi sema amen. Kama huduma inaendelea sema amen. Kama tunaendelea sema amen. Kwa hivyo imefika wakati wa speeches, maongezi tu madogo kidogo tu kutoka kwa viongozi ambao wako hapa siku leo wanahudhuria. Maana tuko kwa Cathedral Parish. Hapa sasa inaitwa Cathedral Parish. Kama kuna Mkristo ambaye hajui Cathedral Parish. Cathedral ndio kiti naona askofu amekalia siku ya leo. Kwa hivyo najua itakuwa ni vigumu kuzoea. Imebeba kiti ya askofu, imebeba cathedral, na hapa nimebeba nyumba ya askofu. Hapa nimebeba mambo yote ambayo yanahusisha hiyo ofisi ya askofu. Kwa hivyo nimependa kumwita Chairman Paul.
Kwa askofu mpya, our lordship Dennis Dillon, our lordship Bishop Daniel, mapatu wote, brothers, sisters, na Wakristo wenzangu, hamjambo? Hamjambo tena. Mungu ni mwema kila wakati. Shangwe na kuendelea. Nimepewa nafasi hii niweze kuwakaribisha kila mmoja kwenye kathedro yetu pale ambapo tunaweza kuja kwa Mungu na kumpa sifa kwa sababu anastahili. Na kwa sababu kwa nafasi hii naomba kumpatia Mungu shukrani kwa sababu ya maguu yake ambayo wetu na sababu ya kutupatia mchungaji mpya. Mimi nimeanza kuzoea. Wewe umeanza kuzoea? Asante kwa baraka.
Asante sana makofi kwa chama.
Mungu awabariki na mapadre ambao wako nyuma yake, mshikane mkono ili tuweze kusukuma hii huduma ya Mungu akubariki sana.
Asante kwa mama Askofu pia, Askofu mkuu na padri, brothers, sisters and sisters. Kwa Kristo wenzangu na wasalimu katika jina la Yesu. Mungu ni mwema na kila wakati. Lazima tufanye nini? Lazima tutoe. Mimi natoa salamu kwa Baba aliyekuwa na leo saa hii.
Mungu ni mwema kila wakati na kila wakati. Kwanza natoa fursa hii kumshukuru Mwenyezi Mungu, pili kwa baba Mashamu, Askofu pia Kidenisilile kwa kuitikia mwaliko huu na kuwezesha siku ya leo kuwa askofu wa kwanza
kanisa letu tawaza tukiona kwa macho. Mimi niko na furaha kubwa kwa siku ya leo ambapo Mwenyezi Mungu ameiteua. Kwa hivyo hata kila mmoja wetu natumai ako na furaha, na tuzidi kuwaombea baba askofu mkuu ili hata na yeye aendelee kumsaidia kwa hii kazi ya kiungwana. Kwa mapadri wetu tunawashukuru sana, tunawaombea mzidi kumsaidia padri askofu mpya kwa hii kazi na kitume ambayo ni mpya kwake, ambayo inahitaji mengi. Kwa maombi yenu, ataweza kukamilisha kazi ambayo Mwenyezi Mungu alimuanzishia. Kwa Wakristo, Mungu azidi kuwaongezea imani na sana sana kuliombea kanisa letu. Kwa dear brothers and sisters, tuendelee kumwombea Baba Askofu mkuu na askofu mpya, ili waendelee kuongoza kanisa kama vile watumishi wake Petro na Paulo walivyokuwa wakiongoza kanisa.
Ingia kwa upande wa mabadhi, na kwa maana saa imeenda sana, ningependa kuita tu padri mmoja, kualika tu padri mmoja aongee kwa niaba ya mapadri wote, Father Thomas.
Asante kwa Baba Askofu mkuu na kwa askofu mpya Askofu Pindelis, na kwa mapadri wote, kwa ma brothers seminarians, sisters na viongozi tofauti tofauti. Mungu ni mwema
kila wakati,
na kila wakati. Wacha niseme ya kwamba tunasema wakati wa Mungu ndio wakati ule mwafaka, kwa maana tumekuwa wakati mwingi tulikuwa tunanuia kwamba tutapata hii daraja kwa padri kwa askofu wetu, lakini ilikuwa ni ngumu, kulikuwa na kazi nyingi sana ilikuwa inatuzuia. Lakini kwa saa hii nasema wakati wa Mungu ndio wakati ule mwafaka zaidi. Kwa hivyo nasema ni asante kwa Mungu kwa haya ambayo ameona ni vema tuweze kuwa na askofu wetu, askofu ambaye tumetembea naye akiwa shemazi, akiwa padri, mpaka hadi sasa ambaye amepata hiki cheo ambacho ni cha kusimamia kanisa, ambacho ni cha kulinda na cha kuongoza kanisa. Basi mimi nataka kumwambia kwamba azidi kuwa kiongozi wa kuongoza kondoo wa Mungu jinsi alivyoweza kupata maagizo kutoka kwa askofu mkuu. Na yetu kama mapadri ni kumshika mkono, kumuombea na kuwa na yeye kwa karibu, ili kazi hili liwe rahisi kwake kuongoza kanisa liende mbele na zaidi ya pale tulipo. Na kwa Wakristo wote nataka kusema ni shukrani kwenu, hasa kwa kuweza kukubali mwaliko ambao ulikuwa ni mfupi, mkaweza kuitikia, angalau kuwe na wakushuhudia na kuweza kusema sisi ni shahidi. Kwa hivyo asante sana kwa wale ambao wametoka mbali na wakaweza kufika hapa na kuweza kushuhudia sherehe iliyo hapa. Mwisho kabisa nikumbusho kwa mapadri wote na viongozi wote, tujue ya kwamba kuna workshop iko karibu. Tuko na workshop iko karibu ya makatekista wetu. Na hivyo basi kuna yale ambayo tuliweza kuandika katika mitandao ili tuweze kuzingatia hayo, ndiposa kazi ambayo ni ya kitume iweze kuendelea na mbele. Asante sana na Mungu awabariki.
Tutaimba wimbo moja, nimeahidi Yesu.
Wakristo wamekuwa shahidi, masista tumekuwa
kuwa shahidi, vijana chipukizi wamekuwa shahidi, ili tuweze kuona huduma ikiendelea. Tumsifu Yesu Kristo. Cha pili tena ningependa pia kumpongeza mashamu wa maskofu kwa kututoa chini, ametutoa chini mahali alitupata na anazidi kutupeleka juu. Namna vile huyo wimbo unasema, ningependa kumpongeza sana, maana mahali alitupata atuko siku ya leo, siku ya leo kupitia mikononi mwake shamba wa maskofu amehakikisha ya kuwa amepata pia msaidizi. Sasa tumepata maskofu wawili katika kanisa letu, pigie shangwe. Kwa hivyo tunaendelea na tunaendelea. Kwa hivyo ningependa kumpongeza sana baba askofu kwa kuhakikisha ya kuwa amepata msaidizi katika kanisa. Yule ambaye alikuwa pamoja wakishavaa kofia sasa wanaonekana kama wazee wazee. Sema amen. Pia tunasema sasa, maana leo ni rasmi tumepata kiti cha kapetro. Kwa hivyo ukiingia hapo utaona hii kiti imefunikwa pale. Tuna kitambaa kitatumika kufunika hii kiti pale. Kiti ambayo hatutakisika kaka. Kiti ambayo hakuna mtu ambaye atakaa. Kiti ya askofu katika kipindi hiki. Tumepata kapetro kirasmi. Tumepata bisho kwa kapetro ni kirasmi ambaye anaishi hapa, ambaye atakuwa karibu na sisi hapa, ambaye atakuwa anatuhudumia hapa na kusambaza dini. Sema nyenyekevu. Tunaidi tutakuwa askofu wetu, tutasambaza dini alipopote kwa Yesu wetu wema, tumsuke. Kwa hivyo weka tayari mikono, weka tayari mikono ili tuweze kumkaribisha kwa makofi ya pili. Moja, mbili, tatu. Moja, mbili, tatu.
Thank you. to the leaders and he encouraged us
in reverence and character, honor the invitation and come. For those who didn't come, I don't expect any excuses. I don't know how to say that, because I don't know how to say it. I say it, and I'm telling people not less than twice. Bishop said it, and he reminded people not less than twice. So, already the revolution is with us, and I want to encourage you one of us. Whenever you are invited, we don't ask for the invitations. Many of us like to go to being invited whenever they are given an invitation at the meeting. But if you are being invited, don't take it for granted. Always when you always invite you, there is an agenda and a very important agenda for that. So we want to thank all those who have honored the invitation. Please who are all leaders who are leaders who are part. I've said I have been very pleased by the one there, Easter's and dinner celebration, and very soon we are now moving to part two of dinner celebration. Firstly, I want to thank your grace. Is now the level we are calling your grace. Your grace most reverent. Now, from today's celebration event, what's are taking place here? Our diocese are moved from the level of diocese to archdiocese. Now, it's an archdiocese. He is no longer bishop, but an archbishop. We used to call that your lordship, but now it's your grace. Your grace as bishop. Governing and leading, presiding, the whole archdiocese. Now we are archdiocese. Archdiocese of Blessed Child of Christ the Nation, presided over by archdiocese and bishop. We are here. When we started working together from 2019, from 2019 to this time, close to 4 years. I want to say our desire impressed so much by his way of leadership. I've been very much blessed. I've liked his way of leadership. He has been a source of encouragement to me. He has been a good leader in my priesthood, and he has been delighted in this moment. So I want to thank you in a very special way, sincerely from my heart, the presence of all this. And that's why I want to say, I want to elevate you at Lisaya. I was proud of that. And I said, no. The way we have been working together for those last 4 years, let us continue working together in that brotherly love and that fellowship which we need in our church. For our love is here, for our church is here. We need to work together and live together, but not alone. Two minds are always better than one. So I only want to promise that I will be always be close to him, consulting when and where necessary, that may unify these diocese and take these diocese from the level which it is now to another level. So Bishop, thank you so much. Bishop, thank you so much for seeing to us that I be embedded in the homage which I've been given. I want to thank my brother priest, brothers of the priesthood, for those years we have worked together at their level as a priest, being their leader as a general. I know they are serious, committed, and activists. And we are not here because of material needs. I've said our cause is enough. And we need people who are very much committed, who are very serious, who love the church and also the ministry, and who don't need to be supervised, that they can serve. Our vocation is a relation to serve, to service. Let us serve in unity, and I know together we shall take the love of those houses to another level. To our sisters, brothers who are in formation, feel encouraged. We love you and we care for you, and we want to be encouraged. And to one time, we see that where you are, as a seminarian. And I say there's an argument for 18 years, for 14 years, as an argument. But now, I'll begin a large office. I live in the great office in the church, being a God bishop. So be encouraged. If God has told me not to go to my glory, men tried to grow me, but they were not able to it. That's why now I'm where I am. So be encouraged. I want to say thank you to our Christians, to our leaders who honored the invitation you came. You came to also asking for the agenda. Those who would have come because of the agenda did not show up, but you showed up. So thank you so much for honoring the invitation, and we are here. The public administration, the Venetians, and all of us, also in preparation, in decorating our church, for the success of the day, and for the success of this Easter dinner celebration. Feel blessed and be loved. My church, that you want to see,
Ilipotea kwa kutoka kwa kijana kutoka
Maulana sana kwa administration kwa afuwa oji sika na mwezo ni kwa kwa nukua kwa 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 because once we are ready, we are ready to ask us. And you don't want one glass of the money. You want to use the glass of the one in the United States. Or, if you don't want to be in the United States, you don't want to be in the United States. You don't want to be in the United States. You don't want to be in the United States. You don't want to be in the United States.
Even without knowing the agenda of the day, Sunday is Sana. At least I'm going to go to the house. 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 I'm going to go to the house.
kuweza kumini. Hati maleni, alogea.
Bwana wenani mwenyezi na wamu.